3 hours of traveling, we're finally here.
You can't learn to be a geologist until you go out in the field and learn this stuff.
So the Azores Islands are in the middle of the Atlantic Ocean. I would say off the coast of Portugal, but they're about 1,000 miles away from Portugal. They're a group of 9 islands.
We went to the Azores for 2 reasons: to see the material that we studied about the volcanic processes that formed those islands in the classroom. Also to get a chance to learn field geology, what it's like to be out there studying, measuring, learning about geology outside of the classroom.
And you might come up with a hypothesis of trying to understand, how is everything I'm seeing here in the field connected? What's the story? What's the process that led to the deposition of these rocks?
We just spent 2 hours taking some measurements of some fumaroles in a volcanic field, and now we're gonna turn them into a really awesome map that we're gonna combine with data of the gases that came out of those volcanic vents to see if we can find any interesting correlations.
So the field notebook was something that we had with us every second of every day, and I wasn't expecting to put so much information in it as I did. Didn't really come in knowing how to draw, but I learned a lot about how to draw so that I would be able to interpret what I saw.
Doing a careful drawing forces you to make really detailed observations. And so very quickly you get to an outcrop, you might connect the dots and think you understand what you're seeing. But when you're forced to draw it and do it very carefully and accurately, you may realize that actually what's there is not quite what you thought at first.
In a volcanic setting such as the Azores, there's a lot going on underground. And some of that includes gases that, instead of coming out of a big cone, like you might think, they simply seep out of the soil.
So at the University of the Azores, they have a volcanic monitoring center, and they are keeping constant tabs on a number of different measurements. So they measure seismology, so earthquakes in the entire vicinity of the Azores. And the other thing that they talked quite a bit about was monitoring volcanic gas emissions.
It's important to measure that for both safety of the residents, and also it tells a story about what's going on underneath the ground.
Geology is a historical science in many respects. And so, you know, we're presented with this evidence of events that have occurred in the past. And our job is to piece those events together and try to understand, what is the story? What is the history of the various events that have occurred? And can we use that to understand the Earth better, understand Earth history better, and understand what will happen in the future?